Hello everyone, my name is Danny. In this video, I'd like to show you how easy it is to replace parts on the oxygen helmet.
If you need to replace parts, it's extremely easy. Within a few minutes, you can replace most of the helmet's components. That's what we want to demonstrate in this video, but we strongly recommend you consult the oxygen helmet's operator's guide before replacing any parts.
Let's start with the face shield. With the two electrical contacts embedded into the pivot, there are no apparent wires. This is why it's so easy to remove and replace without any tools. Let me show you how it's done.
First, it's helpful to place the helmet on a flat surface or on your lap while seated. Then, move the face shield into the utmost position. On one side, pull the lever of the face shield mechanism downward to release the lower tab. Move the lower portion of the face shield pivot upwards until the lower tab is released from the face shield mechanism. Do the same on the other side to remove the face shield. The sun visor is available in different colors to be purchased as accessories, and it too can be removed very quickly. You just have to pivot the sun visor to the lower position, pull the sun visor downward until you see the upper edge, then pull straight forward, one side at a time to remove it.
The face shield mechanism was also designed to be easily replaceable if ever required.
With the face shield off, like we have it now, simply remove the three screws before carefully lifting the mechanism. Make sure to gently pull the wires out of the shell. Once you have access to the back of the mechanism, unscrew the wire terminal to disconnect the mechanism from the helmet circuit. Again, don't pull directly on the electrical wires to avoid any damage.
For increased visibility, this helmet is equipped with a rear light, which turns on when you are connected to your vehicle and the engine is running.
This component also integrates the E-Link connection housing. If you ever need to replace it, remove the BRP logo sticker just below the rear light and remove the two screws that you see here. Grab the rear light module by the bottom and lift it gently. Pull the rear light module downward while lifting the bottom until you clear the two hooks at the top of the rear light module. If the wires are stuck in the shell, don't force the rear light module. Grab the wires and gently pull them out. Finally, disconnect the connector by grabbing it and pulling in opposite directions.
The 360-degree protective collar, which reduces wind intrusion, is also easy to remove for washing.
Simply take one side of the protective collar and pull it out of its fitting. Release the neck pad by pulling gently upward to disengage the plastic strip. Then, pull the second notch out of its fitting on the other side. The protective collar is also attached on the chin portion by four arrow snaps. To fully remove it, pull gently on the chin portion towards the center of the helmet. On the front section, an optional LED light can be installed with two screws. If you want to install it, it's easier with the protective collar removed like we have it here, so you have full access inside the helmet. For this component, you can change the batteries when needed by removing the two smaller screws on the back cover using the screwdriver provided with the LED light.
The oxygen helmet is equipped with noise reduction ear pads, which can be adjusted for comfort by following a few simple steps.
Before any adjustments, we suggest you consult the proper fit section of the helmet's operator's guide. When ready, place the helmet upside down in front of you so that the visor is pointing downwards. Verify that the ear pads are correctly held in place by the Velcro. Next, put on your helmet to determine your ideal pad position. If adjustments are required, take off your helmet and move the pad's position to align with your ears. If your head measurements match the size you are trying, but it feels too snug on the sides of your head, before going to a larger size, remove the noise control system pads from the helmet and take the pads apart. As a side note, if you wanted to install a communication system, this step would be required to install the speakers. For the information on the communication system installation, consult the oxygen helmet's operator's guide. Going back to adjusting the fit, remove the black sealing ring from the mesh. Reassemble and reinstall the pads.
As you can see, the oxygen helmet features many great components that elevate the riding experience. It was designed so that if you decide to remove or install any of these components, it's really easy to achieve. I hope the information I've shared here will help you better enjoy your oxygen helmet and I'll see you in the trails.